And see what we are interested in transpersonal psychology is information. So we are the whole universe in the sense that we, under certain circumstances, can experience ourselves as any part of the universe. It has nothing to do with our physical existence. Like if I'm if I identify with an elephant, it doesn't mean I'm going to weigh 3 tons when you put me on a scale. But I just have the information about what it is like to be an elephant. I have the experience of that. And so each of us has the potential, although, you know, we will not come anywhere close to experience it all. It's just, you know, practically infinite. I talked to Tim Leary after he had about 1,000 psychedelic sessions when I visited him in Millbrook, 1965. And I wanted to know what happens to him when he takes LSD after he had taken it 1,000 times. And he said, oh, the archives of the psyche are inexhaustible. There's always something. So anyway, so we don't experience it all, but we have the potential. I mean, we have the potential to become anything that's part of the universe, including the creative principle. You know, this, in the Upanishads, they ask you, they pose the question, who are you? And the answer is Tattvam Asi, you are that, thou art that, you are Godhead, you are not Nama Rupa, you are not name and shape. So again, this refers to our capacity to have the experience of full experiential identification with the divine source, with the divine source itself. This actually led to my coining a term for this category of experiences that I was studying. They had healing potential, transformative and evolutionary potential, to call them holotropic, moving toward wholeness. You know, this gives us the potential to experience the totality of who we are, whereas in everyday consciousness we experience just certain very, very insignificant fraction of our full potential.